This is R.D. Sharma Solutions, Class 11, Chapter 9, Trigonometric Ratios of Multiple and Submultiple Angles, Exercises 9.1. Here, because we have this as 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 4, like this, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3, 4, 5, like this. So either you can use the direct formula or we can do it step by step. For example, just multiply 2 sine 65, sine pi by 65 and 2 sine 60 pi by 65 in the numerator and denominator. Now if you take this, this will be 2 sine theta cos theta, so it will be sine 2 theta, sine 2 into pi by 65. Now again multiply numerator and denominator and this will become again sine 2 theta, so sine 4 pi 60 by 65. Now again multiply numerator denominator by 2, this will again be sine 2 theta, sine 2 into 4 pi by theta, that is sine 8 pi by 65. Now again multiply this by 2, so every time you have to multiply numerator and denominator by 2. So what do you get? You get 2 sine, that is sine into 2 into 8 pi by 65, so you get this one. Again use 2 in the numerator and denominator. You get 2 sine 32 pi by 65, same thing, 2 numerator and denominator, you get sine 2 into 32 pi by 65, so 64 pi by 65. So here you get 64 pi by 65, here pi by 65. Now you can write this one, 64 pi by 65, as pi minus pi by 65, because pi minus pi by 65 is this one only. Now sine pi minus theta is sine theta, so it will be pi sine pi by 65, this gets cancelled, so you get 1 by 64. Here you have 2 tan alpha equal to 3 tan beta, and we have to prove that tan alpha minus beta is equal to this term. So when we have this one, this type of thing, we just take first the tan beta by tan alpha, and here you will have 3 by 2. Now when this is a ratio, 10b can be written as 3, let us say we have 3k by 2k, k it already gets cancelled. So 10b can be written as 3k and 10 alpha this is. So 10 beta can be written as 3k and 10 alpha can be written as 3k and 10 beta can be written as 2k. Now 10 alpha is 3k and 10 beta is 2k. Now let us take this one which has to be proved in the question. So 10 alpha minus beta. 10 alpha minus beta, use the formula. In place of 10 alpha, put 3k. In place of 10 beta, put 2k. So, do you get k by 1 plus 6k square? So, this is k square. Now, take the right hand side, which is this one. Now, put again or convert it into the tan terms, tan theta terms. So, sine 2 theta or sine 2 beta is 2 tan beta by 1 plus tan square beta. And this is 5 minus cos 2 beta. Cos 2 beta is 1 minus tan square beta by 1 plus tan square beta. So this tan beta, now again put it as 2k and tan alpha as, it is not tan alpha, only tan beta is there. So just put these and just solve it. You will get k by 1 plus 6k square, and these two are equal, that is why the left hand side is equal to right hand side. Now you have sine alpha plus sine beta equal to a and cos alpha plus cos beta equal to b. You have to find out the values of cos alpha minus beta and sine alpha plus beta. Cos alpha minus beta and sine alpha plus beta. So, first of all, the trick here is just square these two equation and add left hand side with left hand side, right hand side with right hand side. So, this square plus this square. So, you get sine square alpha sine square beta plus 2 sine alpha sine beta. Here you get cos square alpha cos square beta plus 2 cos alpha cos beta. Now, here you get a square, you get b square, a square plus b square. Now, this sine square alpha and this cos square alpha will become 1. Sin square beta and cos square beta will become 1. Take 2 common from here. So take 2 common from here, you will get sin alpha sin beta plus cos alpha cos beta, that is eventually equal to cos alpha minus beta. Now these 2 you can take it here. So 2 cos alpha minus beta is a square plus b square minus 2. So cos alpha minus beta is simply a square plus b square minus 2 by 2. Now here sin alpha plus sin beta is a and cos alpha plus cos beta is b, which is given in the question. Now use the formula. This is 2 sin alpha plus beta cos alpha minus beta by 2 equal to a. This will be 2 cos alpha plus beta by 2 and cos alpha minus beta by 2. Now you can divide these two. This gets cancelled. Okay. This gets cancelled. So what do you get? Sin alpha plus beta by cos alpha plus beta equal to a by b. That is tan alpha plus beta equal to a by b. So this you already got, cos alpha minus beta. Sin alpha plus beta we have to find out. So use the formula of 2 sin alpha plus beta in terms of tan alpha plus beta by 2. So sin alpha plus beta is 2 tan alpha plus beta by 2 by 1 plus tan square alpha plus beta by 2. Put a by b in place of tan alpha plus beta by 2. What do you get here? 2ab by a square plus b square. So this we have already done, this just now. Now here we have 2 tan alpha by 2 tan beta by 2. We have to prove that this cos alpha is equal to 3 plus 5 cos beta by 5 plus cos beta. So 2 tan alpha, so take this tan term together. So tan alpha by 2 by tan beta by 2 will be equal to 1 by 2. Now as I said, this is 1k, this is 2k. So tan alpha by 2 you can use as 1k and tan beta by 2 you can use as 2k. Now cos alpha, use the cos alpha formula. Cos alpha is what? It is simply 1 minus tan square alpha by 2 and 1 plus tan square alpha by 2. We are using this one. So cos alpha can be written as 1 minus k square by 1 plus k square. We have used k in place of tan alpha by 2. Now coming to the right hand side, 3 plus 5 cos beta. But because we know that cos beta we can always write as 1 minus tan square beta by 2 and 1 plus tan square beta by 2. So in this place cos beta we have used. Now this tan beta by 2 we have 2k. So just put in place of tan beta by 2, 2k. So just resolve it, you will get 1 minus k square by 1 plus k square. From this equation and this equation, it is clear that these two are equal. We have cos theta as this term. Now you have to prove that tan theta, this tan theta by 2 is equal to plus minus tan alpha by 2 into tan beta by 2. So here cos theta is what? Cos theta, it can be written as 1 minus tan square theta by 2 by 1 plus tan square theta by 2. Now just equate this. Cos theta, just put this one. So 1 minus tan square theta by 2, 1 plus tan square theta by 2 is equal to cos alpha plus cos beta by 1 plus cos alpha cos beta. Now we'll use the component and dividend. This plus this in the numerator and this minus this in the denominator. Similarly here, this plus this in the numerator, this minus this in the denominator. So what do you do here? First of all, see tan square gets cancelled, you will get 2 in the numerator. Here 1, 1 gets cancelled, you will get tan square theta by 2 and tan square theta by 2 of minus. So minus 2 tan square theta by 2. So it will be minus here. Here if you see, the numerator, this is simply 1 plus cos alpha into 1 plus cos beta. You just multiply it. 1 plus cos beta. So 1 plus cos beta. Then cos alpha and cos alpha cos beta. So cos alpha and cos alpha cos beta. So what do you get? You can write it as 1 plus cos alpha, 1 plus cos beta. Now you can take a minus common from here. Minus common from here. When we take minus common, this will be simply 1 minus cos alpha and 1 minus cos beta. So this minus which was here by this minus, because tan square theta by 2 minus and minus tan square theta by 2 was minus. So this minus gets cancelled. Now here, in this you can use the formula of this 1 plus cos alpha, like 1 plus cos alpha is 2 sin square alpha by 2. Similarly, this will be 2 sin square beta by 2. This will be 2 cos square alpha by 2. This will be 2 cos square beta by 2. So what do you get here? This tan theta by 2. Now you can take root on both the side. Tan square theta by 2 and root here also. 2 gets cancelled. Here you get sin and cos. Once this one sin and one cos, it will be sin square, it will be tan square alpha by 2. This one. Tan square alpha by 2. And this you will get tan square beta by 2. So this is tan square theta by 2. Now you can take root on both the side. So tan theta by 2 is simply plus minus because we have taken a root. So it will be tan alpha by 2, tan beta by 2. The square will cancel because of the root. Next is this one. Sec theta plus alpha plus sec theta minus alpha is equal to 2 sec theta. Now you have to prove that this cos theta will be equal to plus minus root 2 cos alpha by 2. So if you see here, first we will write this as 1 by cos theta plus alpha. This will be 1 by cos theta minus alpha. And this has 2 by cos theta. Now just use this cos theta plus alpha formula. And here cos this cos theta plus alpha. Here cos theta minus alpha. So what do you get here? Now take the LCM. This goes up, and these two gets multiplied. So when they go up, this and this gets cancelled. So it will be 2 cos theta and cos alpha in the numerator. In the denominator, the formula is this a minus b and a plus b. So use the a square minus b square formula. So this a square minus b square, this sin square theta, you have to write it as 1 minus cos square theta. So when you write 1 minus cos square theta, what do you get? First, let us multiply on the cross multiply. So cos theta cos alpha cos theta. So it will be cos square theta cos alpha. The left hand side you get here. On the right hand side, you can take it here. So this will be cos square theta. Now what we have done here is, if you multiply this sin square alpha and sin square alpha and sin square cos square theta that you get here. Now when you take a minus, it will be minus sin square alpha plus sin square alpha cos square theta. So in this cos square theta sin square alpha, because it will be plus, minus minus will become plus, you can take cos square theta common from here and from here. So when you take cos square theta common, it will be cos square plus sin square alpha, and this minus sin square alpha will remain here. Now this sin square alpha plus sin square plus cos square is 1. So just put it 1. Now you can, this is cos square theta minus sin square alpha. What you can do here is, you can bring this cos square theta here and sin square theta here. So we are bringing this here and sin square alpha here. So what do you get? This all is already 1. So cos square theta minus cos square theta cos alpha when this comes here. So you can take cos square theta common. So it will be 1 minus cos theta minus cos alpha, and sin square alpha is already here. Now this cos square theta, you can take this 1 minus cos alpha in the denominator, and 1 minus cos alpha is simply 2 sin square alpha by 2. Now here this one you can write it as 2, this is sin square alpha, so it is 2 sin alpha cos alpha, and since it is a square, so it will be 4 sin square alpha by 2 cos square alpha by 2, and you already have a 2 sin square alpha by 2. So this sin square alpha by 2, sin square alpha by 2 cancels, 2 cancels 2, so it will be 2 cos square alpha by 2. Now since it is square, take a root here, so 2 cos square alpha by 2 root is under root 2 cos alpha by 2 plus minus. Now we have cos alpha plus cos beta equal to 1 by 3, and sin alpha plus sin beta is 1 by 4. So same thing we are going to do, square both the sides, left hand side add with left hand side, right hand with right hand. So now square this one and square this one and add, square this one and square this one and add. What do you get? Cos square alpha and sin square alpha is 1, cos square beta sin square beta is 1, and then take 2 common from these two. So you get cos alpha cos beta sin alpha sin beta. Here you get 25 by 144. Now in this you see this 1 plus 1 is 2. You can take 2 here. So 25 by 144 minus 2 is this term. And this simply is cos alpha minus beta. So now take 2 in the denominator as well. Cos alpha minus beta is this one. Now cos alpha minus beta by 2 is simply under root 1 plus cos alpha minus beta by 2. This formula we already know. So now use this here. So when you use this here, you'll get plus minus 5 by 24. This value as cos alpha minus beta by 2. Next is sin alpha is 4 by 5. Cos beta is 5 by 13. Now you have to prove that cos alpha minus beta by 2 is 8 by under root 65. So if you see here, cos alpha minus beta, we need to find out this. So let us start with cos alpha minus beta. I am pretty sure that sin alpha is this, cos alpha you can find out, cos beta is this, you can find out sin beta, because these two are given. This can easily computed by the triangle. Now cos alpha minus beta, so this is the formula, put all these values, you get 63 by 65. Now cos alpha minus beta, you can always write as under root 1 plus cos alpha minus beta by 2. In cos alpha minus beta, you can put this value. So what do you get? This value, plus minus 8 by under root 65. Now we have this A cos 2 theta plus B, this B sin 2 theta equal to C. Now you have to prove this one, tan alpha plus beta equal to B by A. So when you use this cos 2 theta and sin 2 theta, you can write these in the terms of tan. So cos 2 theta is 1 minus tan square theta by 2, 1 plus tan square theta by 2. Sin 2 theta is 2 tan theta, 1 plus tan square theta. Now put in here. When you put this here, see A, 1 minus tan square by 1 plus tan square. I am putting cos 2 theta as this one. Plus B, 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta. Equal to B, C. Now these denominator are same. So just take this here and put it on the right hand side. Multiply it on the right hand side. So C, 1 plus tan square theta. Here what do you get? A, 1 minus t square plus B, means A, 1 minus tan square theta plus 2B tan theta. This is what you get here. Now here just bring all these on the left hand side and rearrange them. You will get an equation like this. Now this is an equation, quadratic equation, in the where the quadratic x square is, x is tan theta actually. So when x is tan theta here, so it's a quadratic equation in terms of tan theta. So we know that the alpha plus beta, tan this alpha plus beta is minus b by a, and alpha minus alpha into beta is c by a. So here use this formula, tan alpha plus beta is tan alpha plus tan beta by 1 minus tan alpha tan beta. Now use these, this 2b by c plus a in the negative term, and c minus a by c plus a. Just put it here in these, tan alpha plus tan beta, this one, and 1 minus tan alpha tan beta, in this tan alpha tan beta you put this one. So it will be b by a. Then you have cos alpha plus cos beta and sin alpha plus sin beta equal to 0. You have to prove this. So simply you just have to square both the sides and just equate. So because both are zeros, so when you equate, this is cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus 2 cos alpha cos beta. This is sin square alpha plus sin square beta plus 2 sin alpha sin beta. And now what we'll do, this cos square alpha, now bring this cos square here. So cos square alpha minus sin square, this cos square alpha minus sin square alpha will be cos 2 alpha. Bring this one here, cos square beta minus sin square beta will be cos 2 beta. Now bring this one here, so you get 2 sin alpha sin beta minus 2 cos alpha cos beta. Now you can take this 2 and minus common. When you take minus 2 common, this will have a formula of cos alpha plus beta. So this will be minus 2 cos alpha plus beta. So these were the question and answer of this topic. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.